menstruation defines a skin that is in an unhealthy state versus a skin that's in a healthy state. As you can see, what's missing is the lipid action within this water reservoir. Water resides in the stratum corneum up to 10%. The idea of water and lipids working together to form our intercellular matrix. It is our natural moisture factor. This natural moisture factor has two components, which is water and lipids. Some skin spends its time over cleansing, over exfoliating. Could be external factors like environmental factors, a very active skin, but without taking the time to replenish that skin. Can leave that skin in a transepidermal water loss state. And the reason for the transepidermal water loss state? Because of the lack of not just water, but also lipids. Notice that this unhealthy skin has a sparse amount of lipids. That lipid barrier is very important for the skin to have receptivity, to help with the protection of the skin barrier, to help preserve, maintain the action of the immunology of the skin, to maintain the natural pH adjuster that we have in our skin. Without an equal amount or without a balance to this lipid and water production, it becomes a compromised skin, which means that the skin could have hypersensitivity, capillaries could be more visible, and as far as the dehydration of that water loss, the skin could be crepey, it could be flaky. So most people talk about water, but water only is half the battle. That lipid protection that is along the side of that water reservoir is very important to maintain a perfect balance to the skin. Now look at the healthy portion of this skin. This skin has complete layering of lipids that help to align itself to that water reservoir. It is intact. It is completely solid. This type of skin is well balanced. It's more receptive. It has more bounce. This is what we refer to as a healthy young skin. So as we get older, we lose more of this lipid concentration to our intercellular matrix or to our natural moisture factor. And with this, we have to reinforce it by using lipids in our cosmetic formulations, our skincare formulations. Now, if you have an oily skin that is dehydrated, a lot of those lipids are going to be sparse because what is the first thing an oily skin does is try to remove any excess oil, and it keeps going on and on and on like a vicious cycle when we actually should be balancing that lipid and water reservoir to help to regulate the functionality of their natural sebum production. So this is where we say more is not better, because too much of more can lead with an unhealthy skin function. But if we present the skin with a balance of the right skincare products and the right home care routine, you're going to have a skin that is, the integrity of the skin is stronger. Again, you have that bounce to the skin. It snaps back. And you have a more receptive skin. So every time you see that client that has a very well-balanced skin, you can push the envelope just a little bit at a time, because the skin is going to repair better. It's going to recover, and it's going to replenish itself to a whole other level than when you're working with more of a sensitized, compromised, a skin that has a low integrity point of its own natural protection. So unhealthy versus healthy is something that we strive to make sure that we meet our clients' goals and expectations, because a healthy skin is a younger looking skin. A unhealthy skin, of course, is going to accelerate the signs of aging. So there's many factors that we have to consistently concern ourselves, and that's with environmental factors, internal factors, that we need to maintain a defensive front so that our skin can repair, recover, and restore its capability naturally. So as skincare professionals, it is very important that we understand this lipid and water reservoir and how important it is for the skin as the whole to protect the integrity of the skin at a deeper level, the immunology of the skin, the productivity of protein enhancement of the skin. All of that depends on the surface integrity, but also it is very important that we understand the delivery of what that product actually does. Is it just a surface action that this product gives the skin, or can it be at a therapeutic action level to help replenish this type of compromised skin and maintain the healthy function of that skin? So I leave you with this information for when you see your next client.